Now we move to the first of the relays. I know a lot of people enjoy these. Great Britain with a chance, very much so, in this 4x100. Australia on the inside, then Brazil, and then in lane three, Great Britain, led off by Jason Gardner. Darren Campbell takes it down the back straight. Marlon Devonish round the top bend, and Mark Lewis Francis hopefully bringing it home safely, first of all, and perhaps, who knows, in a medal position. Nigeria with a strong team. Fasuba, the lead-off man, then Madulu, Egbele, and then Deji Aliu, former world junior champion, on the last leg for them. Favourites, without a doubt, the USA. Sean Crawford, Justin Gatlin, Kobe Miller and Maurice Greene. Two Olympic champions crowned here in Athens. Sean Crawford, of course, over 200, Gatlin over 100, and a former Olympic champion, Maurice Greene, on the last leg. Poland in lane six, Tulin, Chila, Jedrzyński, and then Marcin Urbas on the last leg for them. Outside them in lane seven, the Japanese team, Sushi, Suetsugo, bronze medalist over 200 at last year's World Championships, Takahira, and then Asahara going for them on their last leg. And on the outside, Trinidad and Tobago, one or two names to look out for there. Alexander sets them off, then Mark Burns, then Atto Bolden, former Olympic medalist, and then Darrell Brown, the youngster who was hoping to contest the 100 meters here, was injured. Of course, he won the silver at the World Championships last year, and Brown does go in the relay for them. Australia are on the inside, Basil, DiBella, then Patrick Johnson and Joshua Ross. Difficult draw for them. Essentially, how you want to look at this, it's USA, and if they don't drop the baton, they should win it easily. And then the rest, including Great Britain, have every opportunity. However, anything might happen here. Darren Campbell, Marlon Devonish, and Mark Lewis Francis. If you were watching yesterday, the first changeover wasn't great. Darren went off a little early, and then the last change between Devonish and Mark Lewis Francis was made just in the nick of time. Britain in lane three, USA in lane five. The words were nearly out of my mouth that they get away first time, and then I was going to say Jason Gardner got a great start. Was it too good?
I was just looking at that, Steve. You got a close-up of Jason's back foot. I'm just wondering whether it was Jason that actually triggered the triggered this. We'll wait and see.
Well, while they examine that, I can see, looking down, there's some discussion.
Yeah, they've gone back to the machine to have a look.
But somebody who's now got the opportunity to throw because of this false start is Steve Buckley.
This javelin final is ready for the taking by Steve Buckley. How much does he want it? That is longish, but not long enough for Buckley. He's now got two throws left in this javelin final to make it all come true and take gold.
Jason Gardner was the culprit. Sean Crawford, and actually the news is that we've just been hearing over the last hour or two is that Crawford was put into the team yesterday because John Capel, who might have run for them in qualifying, has failed the drugs test for cannabis, believe it or not. But Crawford definitely would have been in this for the final. He's here now. Jason Gardner gets away equally as well. This time Sean Crawford not so quick out of the blocks for the USA. Now he's into his running, and Crawford moving away. Now first handover. Americans have gone sweetly, so has Darren Campbell got the baton for Great Britain. America already making up ground on Poland outside them. Great Britain very much in this, and Nigerians also going well. Now Gatlin, oh, that wasn't a good change for the Americans. In fact, it was terrible. Kobe Miller with a baton now. Marlon Devonish trying to get Great Britain into this. Nigeria in the lead as they go into the last straight. Mark Lewis Francis has it for Britain in the front. Maurice Greene coming down on him. Mark Lewis Francis has a chance of glory here. Maurice Greene is coming. Mark Lewis Francis gets it, I think. Oh, it was so close! He thinks he's got it! 38.09. What a performance! I said anything could happen, but you know what? I didn't think it would be a gold medal for Great Britain. It's gone up on the scoreboard. It's confirmed. Another gold medal. What a night. Goodness me. They got the baton in the lead, and Mark Lewis Francis brought it home.
That was an astonishing piece of technical baton passing. I was watching him through the binoculars, and it was perfect. Maurice Green, nothing he could do. Bronze medal in the 100, but Mark Lewis Francis held him off. One of the big surprise results here. But the baton passing, the changeovers were absolutely superb all the way round. This time there were no mistakes, and the Americans, well, who would have expected them to have been beaten here? Lewis Francis, absolutely superb, kept his cool. Marlon Devonish ran that third leg brilliantly. Have a look at this. Wonderful piece of baton changing here. How goes the hand? Down it goes, slightly in the lead. And now he's got to hold off some very good sprinters. He's got to hold off Aliyu of Nigeria in the green, Maurice Green of the United States on the near side. Holds his form, keeps his form. Green's closing down, but not enough. And it's just, only just, but it's enough. 38.07. It's a gold medal by 1/100th of a second. Look at that look of determination on a young man. And Green couldn't quite come back, could he? It was so close.
That's very close. And I'm a little surprised that the result got up there straight away. You can see that though, Mark Lewis Francis's chest clearly in front over the far side. And well, what a comeback for our sprinters. So pleased for them. They've been, what about Darren Campbell? He cannot believe it. He's been under the microscope in more ways than one, Darren. They all were, all season long. We've been not criticizing them, but wanting them to perform better, wanting them to show how good they are. And tonight they came good. 1912 was the last time that Great Britain won a relay gold medal. Brendan was there perhaps to see it. None of the rest of us would have been there. But goodness me, remember tonight, Great Britain's relay team have won the Olympic gold medal. A fantastic run, kept their heads when all around them were losing theirs, particularly the Americans. Watch this, this is Gatland to Kobe Miller.
Well, this is where they got into all sorts of bother. Almost a stop. In the old days, we used to say, well, the Americans don't need baton changing. They don't need it. They're so much better than anyone else, and they make up for it on the straightway. But this was the most perfect piece of baton passing. I'll say it again, from Gardner to Campbell, it was terrific. Let's just have a look at it now. Watch this. Jason Gardner, who had the false start, remember, got off absolutely brilliantly. And the takeoff mark is approached now. And look at the way Campbell goes, fully extended arm. That's absolutely perfect down the back straight. Darren Campbell, semi-finalist of the 200 here. Silver medalist 4 years ago in that event. Look at that, extended arm, brilliant. Now, it couldn't have gone better. Devonish now on the bend, running brilliantly, the world indoor 200 meter champion. Hits down into the straight, transition good, and here goes Mark Lewis Francis again. He's got it, and he believes, look at that look, they can't catch me, they mustn't catch me, they daren't catch me. They almost did, but they didn't, and it was gold for Great Britain. It was absolutely stunning. Technically, they could not have got it better.
Well, you know, a couple of times I've seen Mark celebrate this season when I'm not sure what he's been celebrating, but tonight he crossed that line knowing that he had run the leg of his life there. That last change was so sweet, and that's, well, all of the changes, all of the running, of course, contributed to that gold medal, but it was so close in the end. But all of the frustration, the anger released for Darren Campbell. It's been horrendous couple of weeks. He had that hamstring problem in Cyprus, which, okay, we've been wanting to see Darren show what a great athlete he is, and the other three as well have all contributed and have been rewarded tonight with the ultimate prize. Fantastic.
I'm really pleased for Marlon Devonish too, denied a place in the individual 200 meters, but has worked hard, fresh legs on the third leg here. And this is a result so unexpected, but brilliant. Look at that. Britain, the gold.
Should we say it again? Hang on. Great Britain win the gold medal ahead of the United States of America, Nigeria get the bronze.
What an exciting evening. And next on the track, the women's 4x4 relay final. Donna Fre-